반갑습니다. 자기 그런 낮은. I'm very honored to be here. Special thanks to Ibu Hayati Sari Hasibuan and Kosuke Bizumu Sensei for calling me as a keynote speaker. So I'm, though I'm not a big guy, very honored to be here as a keynote speaker. So please take photo me and give me a gift. Today, as a Korean Indonesianist, I would like to propose some challenges for new stage in Indonesia-Korea relations. Next page. More than 40 years of government-to-government relations, G2G relations, both countries, Korea and Indonesia, have formed relations in every sector, from politics to economy. Nowadays, Indonesia-Korea relations have entered a new stage, that is Golden Age. This age is characterized by the development of human dimension beyond government relations. As I insist in my book, RIMS Hubungan Indonesia-Korea, 4 years ago, jadi sekalian promosi buku saya dulu. Terima kasih. The Golden Age is driven by the migration of people from both countries in the last 30 years. Investors and workers pioneered this human dimension. More than 1,500 Korean companies are operating in Indonesia. Industrial trainees from Indonesia arrived first in 1993 Korea. Now, Indonesian staying in Korea are roughly estimated 400,000, of course, mostly workers, and ranked as the fifth largest foreign group in Korea. We live in this new era, and that means we can think of something new and meaningful challenges. These are beyond G2G relations and take us to people-centered relations. Next page, please.
Thanks.
The new Southern Policy, or NSP, a major foreign policy of current Korean government, also gives a vision of people-centered relations. The NSP, or new Southern Policy, that was introduced in 2 years ago, very recently. Korean President Moon, you can see the photo, declared his goal to elevate Korea's relations with ASEAN to the level of its relations with the four major powers. Four major powers means US, China, Japan, and Russia. The goal right there was presented for the first time by the Korean president in Korean history. However, it is a policy that reflects the change of reality. ASEAN already occupied four major powers level in relations with Korea. Look at the table, and at first, the trade level. ASEAN ranked as the second after China. ASEAN has the second largest for investment area Koreans after US. ASEAN visitors to Korea is the third largest after Chinese and Japanese. Korean visitors choose ASEAN at the first site for touring. ASEAN is the fourth most populated region of overseas Koreans after China, US, and Japan. Therefore, the NSP policy can be said to be late to declare. The next page. The NSP, of Korean foreign policy, proposed the principle of three P's. That is people, prosperity and peace. You know already what is peace and what is prosperity. This is similar with ASEAN community principles. But in these three principles, people, it comes first. And then the question is what the people-centered Korea-ASEAN relations is. The next page. There is people-centered relations declared by Korean government. According to Korean government, people-centered approach contains six connotations from one to six. There is first mutual visit. Second, the two-way cultural exchange between Koreans and ASEAN peoples. And then human resource development. Then enhancing government. Five, protecting rights of people. Six, better quality of life. The problem is that officials love a simple indicator as a performance check. So mutual visit, number one. Mutual visit between Koreans and ASEAN peoples is located as a key indicator to pursue. A performance indicator of people-centered vision is superficially set by the increase in mutual visitors. I already contribute because I visited Indonesia today. So target is set by official is 15 million in next year. I think it is too easy to reach. Already done. Instead, I highlight as a chance of plus four principle, four connotation and five connotation and six connotation from four to six connotation as chance for us or SDG or people-centered relations between us. Because the number four includes the civil society networking. Number five includes the support for ASEAN peoples in Korea. And number six includes the cooperation of public health. These are related in SDGs, I think. So we give stress on connotation 4 to 6. The people-centered relations could be regarded as a regional partnership for the SDGs. The whole next phase. For utilizing this chance, at first, I want to suggest healthcare and welfare research cooperation. We think about the welfare reform or healthcare reform in South Asia. Thailand introduced universal healthcare coverage since the Thaksin government, and the experiment is going on for already 15 years. The infant mortality rate of Thai is decreasing drastically. Now Indonesia is chasing Thai towards universal healthcare coverage. Vietnam also reveals relatively nice performance in healthcare through the way of public and private partnership. Healthcare reform, I think, in South Asia provides exciting and dynamic example for welfare studies because it is very rare reform rising from where there are insufficient resources and conditions. However, welfare studies in Korea mainly concentrate on cases from Europe or Japan where the conditions are already mature. For overcoming this academic deficit, I suggest Korea, Japan, ASEAN cooperation for healthcare and welfare studies or East Asian welfare studies network, including Taiwan side and Indian side. We can make some panel in CRCA organized by CS or higher efficiency. CSA conference in 2021, maybe in Indonesia. It would be some big conference. And publish book series of those issues. This is my first suggestion. The next page. Focus on Indonesia and Korea relations for better democracy. Connotation 4-6 of the NSP could be regarded as a connotation of democratic quality. For making democracy meaningful, 4-6 connotation of NSP also need to be strengthened. Indonesia and Korea has democracy as a common value, so we can do something to cooperate for democracy promotion in our region. I already suggest this year for Korea Democracy Foundation, or KDF, to assist to form Indonesia Democracy Foundation, or IDF. It's a new organization. So KDF, I suggest KDF to cooperate to build Indonesia Democracy Foundation. Why the Korea Democracy Foundation? KDF has conducted civic education, research, archiving, and exhibit, especially on the history of struggle for democracy and human rights in Korea. As a slogan of the KDF, a path toward democracy is remembering the dark past and marching to the future. So this activism of KDF is similar with recent Indonesian activism, Melawan Rupa. Memory is related not only to the past, but also to present and future. The memory of the reformers era also promote current activism, the reformasi jilid dua in Indonesia, I think. The next page, last page. Don't misunderstand my project as exporting social movement from Korea to Indonesia. We need to cooperate following the reciprocal way. We need learning each other. As an example, it is in a table, ratification of the ILO co-conventions. Indonesia has ratified all the co-conventions. This achievement was occurred in under the Habibie presidency. Indonesia ratified all the convention, but Korea is not yet. So Korean member side need to explore Indonesian success story. Of course, in the area of transitional justice, Indonesian activism for human rights need to study Korean success story. So Korea is better than Indonesia in transitional justice. Indonesia is better than Korea in accepting international labor standards. So we study each other, learning each other from each other. So I would suggest formation of Indonesia Democracy Foundation as an institution for transitional justice through the cooperation with Korean Democracy Foundation. As the first step, I have planned to publish the Almanac of Solidarity Movement with South Asia in Korea, or change the title, Korea ASEAN Solidarity Movement in Korea, after 3 years of research. Through this book, I will service a directory in English of Korean NGOs which have interest in on South Asian people. At G2G level, in our region, democracy is not a familiar word. Therefore, instead, G2G relations, civil society partnership is more relevant in pursuing better democracy. For enhancing this partnership, we need to know each other. For an example, if you have a problem with Korean companies' misconduct in Indonesia, you need to know which Korean NGOs to be contacted. I will inform you in this arena. The civic partnership like this would be contributing to realize SDGs in our region too. Thank you for listening. 감사합니다.